without the use of visible force or coercion, so that the victims do not realize that they've been conquered, such it is today. Tribute is collected from them in the form of legal debts and taxes. The mother says to the judge, and judge, we were always in debt. See, I saw a cartoon, a mother standing in front of a judge in divorce court, holding the hand of a small boy and girl, right? The hand, well, with her husband sitting in the witness chair, holding his head in gloom. And the mother had the audacity to say to the judge, judge, we were always in debt. America, living in what is called the richest nation on earth, seeing always the shortest on money. The women now working in unprecedented numbers. Husband hoping for overtime to earn more or to take part-time just over broke jobs, evenings and weekends. Children look for odd jobs for spending money. The family debt climbs higher and higher and higher. And psychologist says one of the biggest causes of family quarrels and breakups and arguments is over money. For the love of money. Matthew, my brother, is the root of all evil. The love of money. Not money, but the love of money. Is that what I told you? Too few American people realize why these so-called chairmen and statements and political powers wrote Article 1 of the United States Constitution. Congress shall have the power to coin money and regulate the value thereof. They did this. Yo, they did that, you all. And as the foul-mouthed Kahan will show in prayer for hope, that it will prevent love of money from destroying this nation and restore the republic that was founded. And we're going to see how subdivisions and subversions of Article 1 has brought all this evil of which Yahuwah had won. So I'm going to tell you this, Matthew. Money is the only creation that man has created. Everything else he procreated. Money is man's only creation. See, economists use the term create. They have aphasia. Like Wendy Williams, they have aphasia. I've been using the word for years, so don't say I got it from them. They got it from the foul mouth of Kahan. Economists use the term create when speaking of the process by which money comes into existence. Now, creation means making something which did not exist before. Understand that. We're going to deal with specifics. And if you're not a secure creditor by the time this video over, man, you had a lobotomy. Without being a secure creditor, there's no hope. You got to correct your status. Watch this, watch this. Yahushabim, a lumberman make boards from trees. Workers build houses from lumber. And factories manufacture automobiles from metal, glass, and other material. But in all these, my good brother Matthew, they did not create. They only changed the existing material into a more usable substance. and therefore more valuable form. This is not so with money. Here, and here alone, man actually creates something out of nothing. Creates money out of thin air. A piece of paper of little value is printed so that it is worth a piece of lumber. But they put different figures on it. And it could buy the automobile or even a house. Its value has been created in the meaning of the word. Watch this. Watch this. Creating money is very profitable to banksters, as is seen by the analogy that the foul-mouthed Kahan just provided. Money is very cheap to make, and whosoever does the creating of money in a nation can make tremendous profits. Builders work hard to make profits of 5% above the cost of building a house. Matthew, an auto mechanic, and automakers sell their cars for 1% to 2% above the cost of the manufacturing. And it's considered good business. I need you to hear me. But money manufactures, Matthew. Money manufacturers have no limit on the profit, since a few cents will print a dollar bill or a $1,000 bill. You heard what I told you? The profit is part of a story. But let's first consider another unique characteristic of the things money, the love of which is the root of all evil. Adequate money supply is needed. An adequate supply of money is indispensable in civil society. We could forego many other things, but without money, without the money industry, we'll grind to a halt. Phones would become only self-sustaining units. Surplus foods would disappear. Jobs requiring the work of more than one man or one family will remain undone. Shipping and large movements of goods would cease, and hungry people would plunder and kill to remain alive. An old government except family or tribe would cease to function. Remember what I told you? An overstatement, you say, Khan, tells the doctor. Not at all. Money is the blood of civilized society. So the means of all commercial trade except simple barter. It's the measure and the installment, or the instrument, should I say, by which one product is sold and another is purchased. Remove money or even reduce the supply below that which is necessary to carry out on current levels of trade, and the results will be catastrophic. Watch this. Case in point, Mark. We need only look at the American Depression of the 1930s. Right? And in 1930, America did not lack industry capacity, fertile farmland, skilled and willing workers of industrious farm families. It had an extensive and efficient transportation system and railroad network. It had inland and ocean waterways, communication between regions. Second, man. I'm trying to twist my mic a little bit, man. And localities were the best in the world, utilizing telephones, teletype, radio, and well-operated government mail systems. No war had raged